we decided that we were going to ask some teachers, some educators, some researchers, some people that we were just really interested in talking to, what does effective and ineffective technology use look like in the math classroom?
Using tech tools that empower students in math class to create and manipulate math, and even play with the math, collect their thinking and share it in a way that the whole math community can kind of see what everyone is thinking. That's a powerful way to use tech. It takes a little bit of risk on the teacher side. You have to go off script and be willing to work with that real-timey stuff that kids can do. But that social aspect, that component of the technology helping to bring all of that student thinking efficiently together so we can explore it and dialogue about that, that's powerful. The math belongs to them and not just the math teacher.
I think in a classroom, you're constantly looking at not just content measures, but how students are feeling, how students' stamina is, when they need a break or maybe they need some time off. So maybe you do a week of Khan Academy, and that's very effective because it gives everybody a breather and they get to relax. And then another time, maybe you're doing Desmos activities where they're talking and explaining their thinking. But I think what's most effective is driven first by the students and what their needs are and what their outcomes are in say, previous tasks, and then second, by the content.
One thing I like about using technology in math class is that we get to use lots of online platforms like Zurn and Prodigy. And what I don't like is that we don't get to be in person and have the lesson. I don't like being able to hear what other people think. And it's a lot harder to get the teacher's attention when I want to share something or I have a question in the Zoom meeting.